Good morning, students. You are heartily welcome to this online class. Now, today we are going to start a very new chapter and a very interesting chapter. Chapter 3, Chemical Substances and Processes. We are going to start this chapter. In this chapter, we have to study about the chemical substances and what are the processes through which the formation of formula and chemical equation used to happens. Now, before starting this chapter, let us recapitulate what you have studied in class 6. You have studied matter. Yes, in class 6 you have studied about matter. So first of all, we will discuss about the matter. What is matter? What is matter? Anything that have mass and occupies space, has volume, is called matter. Is that clear, students? Okay. Now, everything around us is matter. Now, let us discuss about the matter. Matter, anything that has mass and occupies space, has volume, is called matter. Everything around us is matter. Students, let us discuss about the matter. Matter, anything that that has mass and occupies space, has volume, is called matter. Everything around us is a matter, means whatever the things that can be touched, they have mass. For example, we take the example of a pen, copy, a coin. When you keep the coin, then it will take the space, and when you pick it up, the coin, you will feel that something you are picking in your hand. Same thing happen with your pen. When you are keeping the pen, wherever you keep it, it occupies that space, and when you pick the pen in your hand, you will feel its weight. So whatever the things mostly present in around us are of called to be as or considered as a matter. Atom and compounds are also made up of small particles of matter. Now, in class 6 also, we have studied about the three states of matter or different three forms of matter. The three forms of matter are solid, liquid and gas. The three forms of matter are solid, liquid and gas. So, let us first of all discuss about the solid. Solid. In solid, let us discuss about the solid. Solid, in the previous 6 we have discussed solids, few characteristics I have written. Definite mass, solid have the definite mass, volume and shape. Why solid have definite mass and volume and shape? Because in class 6 we have studied that solids are what? Solids molecules are what? This is the molecules of solid. So, you can see the molecules of solids are what? Very close, very tightly packed. No intermolecular space. Ye molecule hai, ye molecule. In dono ke beech mein koi space nahi hai. Kisi molecules ke beech mein koi space nahi hai. So, this is called as intermolecular space. Now, next. Short or no intermolecular space, as per we have discussed in this diagram. Strong intermolecular force. When no space will be there, then force of this molecule and these molecules, they will have a strong bonding between them. So they will have a strong intermolecular force. So we can say that due to this only, molecules of the solids are very compactly packed. Let us discuss about the liquid. Previously we have discussed about the solid and its characteristic. Now we are going to discuss about the liquid, its characteristics. First of all, we will See in the diagram. Let me draw the diagram. See, these are the molecules of liquid. So in the molecules of liquid, these are the intermolecular. Intermolecular means molecules between the molecules. This is one molecule, this is one molecule. And between the molecules, some spaces are there. In comparison to solid, in liquid, between the molecules, some spaces are present. So we can say that the intermolecular space is present between the molecules in case of liquid. So now let us discuss the characteristics. Definite volume but indefinite shape. What does it mean? Definite volume means in whatever the container you are keeping the liquid, it will take the shape of that container. If you are keeping the water in a bottle, it will be in the shape of bottle. If you are keeping the water in a utensil, then it will be in the shape of that utensil. If you are keeping the water in a glass or a bowl, then it will be in its shape. Whatever it, wherever you are, but the volume is fixed. How much amount you are taking, it is fixed. If you are taking one glass of water, and that one glass of water either you are keeping in a bottle or in your, you are keeping in a bowl, then the amount, its volume will not change, but the only their shape will change. So it is called as definite volume and indefinite shape. So now it's clear that liquid has a definite volume and indefinite shape. We have discussed about that little more intermolecular space than the solid. In comparison to solid, no space was there between the molecules, but in case of liquid, there is intermolecular. Inter means middle. So between two molecules, space is present. That is called as intermolecular space. Now, less intermolecular force in comparison to solid. So what is intermolecular force? When the two molecules of liquid are near to each other, they are bounded by some bonding. So when a space will increase, so their bonding force will be decreasing. So if the space between the molecules increases, then their bonding force gets to be decreased. That bonding force is called as intermolecular force. But in case of solid, it was higher. But in case of liquid, little space is there. So due to that intermolecular space, intermolecular force decreases. So these are the very special characteristics of liquid that we have studied in class 6. So we are recapitulating all the points because these points are very useful for this chapter. Now next is a very important states of matter. It is one of the form, that is the gas. Now let us have these characteristics. Gases. Gases have neither definite shape nor definite volume. They expand to the size of their container. Is that clear? Neither definite shape nor definite volume. Means its shape is also not fixed, its volume is also not fixed. Wherever you will feel that gases, it will take that shape. Means that if you blow a balloon, and balloon may be heart shape, it will be round in shape, different shapes, then that is the shape of the gases. Now let us talk about the intermolecular space. In case of gases, the molecules are very free. Molecules are very free. They are very apart from each other. Large, you are seeing here, one molecule of gas, two molecule, three molecule, four or five. And a large space is between all these molecules. So this is called as intermolecular space. Ye intermolecular space. So this, between these molecules, large space is there in comparison to liquid. So gases have large intermolecular space, whereas if the space is more, then what will happen? Intermolecular force will decrease. If the space becomes to be larger, then the force gets to be less. So intermolecular space increases, intermolecular force of interaction between the molecules gets to be decreased. So intermolecular force gets to be decreased. So intermolecular space maximum in gas, minimum in liquid, and very less or not in solid. But intermolecular force is maximum in solid, minimum in liquid, and negligible in or very less in case of gases. It's clear, students? All these all are the characteristics of solid, liquid, and gases. Let us discuss about some very special terms related to this chapter. These terms are very important to study or to understand this chapter clearly. So the first term that we are going to understand about the atom. Now, after that we will study about molecules, and then to the element, and then to compounds. These terms are very important for us to learn it. Now let us start with the atoms. The building block of all substance. Atoms are very small particles, and it is considered to be as a building block of all substance. Now molecules. Molecules, the chemical combination of two or more atoms are called as molecules. The combination of two or more atoms are called as molecules. Elements, a substance that is made up of only one type of atom is called element. Now once more, element, the substance that is made of only one type of atom is called element. Compound, a substance formed of same or different element joined chemically are called as compounds. Now pure substance. Now one of the most important term is pure substance. An element or a compound can be considered as pure substance. Mixture. Mixture of previous class 6 also we have studied. It is made up of elements or a compound mixed together in any proportion. It can be elements or compound, but their proportion of mixing is not fixed. So it is called as mixture. Now these terms, atoms, molecule, elements, compound, pure substance, mixture. Let us revise with the help of example. Let us take the example. Now you are seeing here, helium is written. Helium is a gas. So helium is there. So He, helium formula is He. So helium is what? Atom. And helium is a single substance. Only one type of substance is there. So it can also be called as a pure substance. Now next example is H2. Means hydrogen. Means here the hydrogen, H2 is what? Hydrogen means two atom of hydrogen is combining together to form a molecule. See here, one hydrogen is this, one H atom and one another H atom. When these two hydrogen atoms combines to form hydrogen molecules. Now, in case of pure substance, elements or compounds, they are combining together of the same kind. They are of the same kind, means hydrogen combines with the hydrogen to form H2 hydrogen gas. So it is a molecule and it is also a pure substance. Clear? Now, H2O. What do you mean by H2O? H2O is what? H2O is water. H2O is water. Water. Water formula is H2O. So, how the H2O is formed? So, two molecules of hydrogen and one molecule of oxygen forms the H2O. So, two molecules of hydrogen means two. So, two molecules. So, it can be considered to be as a compound. Because in compound, the ratio is fixed. And here the hydrogen and oxygen ratio is what? 2 is to 1. So, 2 is to 1 is fixed. Either you are taking tap water or RO water, any type of black water, pond water, wherever. From wherever you take the water, its formula will never change. Ratio of combination will never change. It will be always 2 is to 1. So, it is a compound. But we cannot say that all compounds are pure substance. But pure substance can be a compound. Okay? So, H2O is a molecule. Because molecule definition is what? The chemical combination of two or more atoms. So, here the hydrogen atom is also there and oxygen atom. Two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen combines together to form water molecules. Okay? So, it is also considered to be as a molecule. Now, atoms, molecule, elements, compound, pure substance and mixture is clear. Mixture means what? Means anything what you are mixing that is not fixed. Just for example, we used to make sherbet. If you are adding in a glass, if you are adding taking water and equal amount of water in a 4 glass, then equal amount of water you are taking in a 4 glass, and in each glass, in the first glass, if you are pouring 1 spoon of sugar, in second 2 spoon, in third 3 spoon, and in fourth 4 spoon. But 1 to 4 glasses you are making what? Sharbat. You are preparing sharbat of sugar. So ratio varies, but preparation is for sharbat. The ratio of the sugar is varying. Water is same, but the ratio of sugar is varying, and still its taste will also vary according to the what proportion you are using. So, when the ratio of the substances are in any proportion, then it is considered to be as a mixture. Clear? Now, atoms consist of electron and nucleus. Means each and every atom consists of electron and nucleus. Whatever you are studying in class 7, you have to study in class 9. And in class 8 also you have to study. So, be careful, make your concept very clear. If you have any problem regarding this chapter, be assured that you will consult to me. Now, next, negative charge particle is called as electron, and positive charge particles are called as proton, and neutral particles are called as neutron. So, in the nucleus, proton and neutrons are present. Inside the nucleus, protons and neutrons are present.
An electron is present outside the nucleus. Clear? Now let us atoms. Atoms combines to form elements. Elements combines to form molecules, and molecules combines to form the compounds. And where the compounds forms the various chemical substances. Clear? So atom is the basic unit, or called as the building block of any substance. Any substance, or means any matter, is made up of what? Atoms. All matters are made up of small particles, that is called as atoms. And when these atoms combines together, they used to form the elements. And when these elements combines together, they used to form molecules. And when many molecules combines together, either they are of the similar kind or they are of the different kinds, they used to form compounds. And when these compounds are further formed, then the chemical substances form. Chemical substances formation takes place, and further the chemical reactions starts taking place. So these all are the brief of this chapters. I have explained you all the terms. Now we will have some assignment work that you will be given in the class, that assignment, that how much you have studied the chapters. View this video carefully and understand it.